I were to put a 10-inch, 30-foot long plank on the ground here and say, if you walk the length of the plank, I'll give you $20. Would you do it? Of course, it's an easy 20 bucks. But what if I took that same plank and made a rooftop bridge between two 100-story buildings? The wind is whipping and the birds are flying. What if I offered you the same $20 for walking across that sky-high plank? Would you do it now? You'd probably look at me and say, no way. However, what if your child was on the opposite building and that building was on fire and the flames were licking at their neck? And if you didn't go across, they would certainly perish and die. Would you walk across that plank to save him or her? Likely your answer would be absolutely and immediately, $20 or not. Why is it the first time I asked you to cross that sky-high plank, you said, no way, yet the second time you wouldn't even hesitate? The risks and the dangers were the same. What changed? Your why changed. Your reason for wanting to do it changed. You see, when the reason is big enough, you will be willing to perform almost anyhow. The power of your why is what gets you to stick through the grueling, mundane, and the laborious. All of the hows will be meaningless until your whys are powerful enough. Until you've set your desire and motivation in place, you'll abandon any new path that you seek to your better life. If your why power, your desire, isn't great enough, the fortitude of your commitment won't be powerful enough, and you'll end up like every other person who makes a New Year's resolution and gives up too quickly and reverts back to living a life of ho-hum and mediocrity. But not you, not anymore.